more. And however hardened lawyers might be, when you see that from a child begging a father to come and see them and they haven't got the funds to and the mother won't accommodate it, it's heartbreaking and it shouldn't be happening.
This isn't a male agenda. It's about, nor the law says, well, there is no such thing as father's rights. I would beg to differ. I would say there's mother's rights, children's rights, and father's rights. But once you have that argument, then you have a parity and equality of rights. And one party's rights cannot be dominant over another's. It just can't be. Then you don't get rights. Then you don't get equality. Then you don't get justice. You get injustice.
The man who's dressed as Spider-Man is still hanging on, bringing massive traffic chaos to the capital. Why is he doing it? He says to protest about father's rights. Our correspondent George Eakin is at Tower Bridge for tonight, George.
Sean, the protest on the crane behind me is now nearing the end of its fifth day. The police are stressing that the Spider-Man character on the skyline will be arrested when he comes down. The problem is for now, he seems in no hurry.
This, says David Chick, is a cry for help to draw attention to the way he claims he's being denied access to his daughter. To others, it's a dangerous stunt which is costing London a fortune and disrupting life for tens of thousands. Mr. Chick from West Sussex scaled the 120-foot crane early on Friday morning. Police attempts then and since to talk him down have failed. He's talked of staying perhaps 10 days. It seems that the self-styled Spider-Man is calling the shots amid murmurs that he may still be up there at the weekend.
Well, the pressure group Fathers for Justice have been trying to persuade Mr. Chick to come down. They're telling him he's successfully drawn attention to the issue of fathers' rights and he should quit now before he loses all goodwill.
And what's his story? What is he protesting about?
Well, I mean, David's case is just typical of the many hundreds every day that happen in the family court. He has lost contact for over 8 months with his 4.5-year-old daughter, Lauren, and he's very, very upset, feels very anguished by the pain and suffering that he and his daughter have gone through, not for any fault of his own, but basically as a result of the injustices of the family court, which basically result in every day 100 children lose contact with their fathers.
Undoubtedly, when they're denied access to their kids.
Well, I think you have to look at a convergence of different things happening at this moment in time with regard to fathers losing contact with their children. One of those convergences is Fathers for Justice and the effect that we've had in less than 11 months.